Today's topic for discussion is a topic of plant pathology, and today's disease for discussion is rust disease of linseed. Linseed, it is a crop. Its botanical is Linum usitatissimum, and the rust disease which is caused by Melanospora linii. This is a fungus. Rust of linseed, it is a very common disease of linseed, and the disease occurs throughout the world. In India, flaxseed or the linseed is extensively cultivated in almost all the states of India. The crop is generally cultivated during October to April, and the disease generally appears in February or later. One of the great plant pathologists, Butler, in 1918, he has observed this disease from central India in the early days of November. At the time of crop harvesting, the affected plants get fired appearance due to the presence of tailial sori. The affected plants do not produce more flowers. Yield is affected. The disease causes serious effect on the plants. Once the disease set in the field, once when the disease occurs in the field, most of the plants in the field, they get affected within very short time. The disease generally appears in epidemic form. Heavily infected plants get mostly defoliated. Defoliation means all the infected leaves fell off on the ground, due to which starch formation is reduced, due to which the photosynthetic activity is reduced. There is no photosynthesis. There is no space on the leaf for photosynthesis because of the rust pustules. Most of the food reserves of the host is consumed by the pathogen, resulting in decrease in the yield of the seeds, and quality of the fiber is also reduced. Oil content of the seed is also affected. Let us see the symptoms of the rust disease of linseed. The leaves are the first to show the symptoms. Mostly the symptoms occur on the leaves. Initial symptoms occur on the leaves, and gradually all the plant parts show rust symptoms except root system. Symptoms are formed in the form of small dot-like structures. Each dot, it is known as pustule. Pustule, it is a group of spores. It is a sorus, and such a small pustules are initially surrounded by chlorotic zone, and little necrosis of the leaves is first observed by its growth, and it becomes more general, and leaves prematurely die because of heavy infection. Even the young leaves, they die or they fell off on the ground. The sorus or the pustules on the leaf are uridopustules. Uridospores are present in that, and uridopustules may also appear on the stem. While the uridopustules on the leaves are round and small, those on the stem are elongated and irregular. This fungus also produces tailial stage. Teletopustules are generally produced on the stem and rarely on the leaves if they have not been shed prematurely. The teletosori are orange yellow in color. Orange yellow uridopustules are often surrounded by reddish brown teletopustules. The content of tailial pustules do not break the epidermis of the host and remain buried epidermially, appearing glossy. Let us see which is the causal organism. The disease which is caused by a fungus and the name of the fungus is Melamspora linii. This is the name of fungus which causes rust disease of linseed. And let us see the disease cycle. This disease is very common in temperate countries of the world. Primary infection takes place through basidiospores, which are produced as a result of germination of teletospores perinating in the soil. The teletospores on the infected plant, they fell off on the ground, and in presence of moisture they germinate and produce as basidiospores on their promycelium. But in typical, in tropical regions of the world, the teletospores produced at the end of growing season, mostly in April and May month, and lose their viability due to excessive heat of the summer. Uridiospores too are killed due to excessive temperature. The uridiospores which occur on the leaves, which the leaves, infected leaves, they fell off on the ground, but because of high temperature in summer season, even the uridiospores, they are killed. It is thought that the uridiospores produced on linseed at hills comes down to the plain to cause infection. Thus, the primary inoculum is wind blown, that is carried by wind, and that comes in contact with the host plant, and on the host plant that the spores germinate, and disease occurs within 2 to 3 months of sowing of the crop. Okay, uridiospores produced as a result of primary infection can cause secondary infection. Since the uridiospores takes very little time to germinate, the secondary infection is caused within a short time. Secondary infection along with primary infection cause heavy damage to the seed crop. Teletospores produced at the end of the growing season appears to have no role to play in a continuation of life cycle of the rust disease on linseed by Melamspora linii. Let us see how to control the disease. For the management of the disease, we have to use resistant varieties for sowing purpose. Okay, this is one of the best method of management. We have to use resistant varieties. Next, we have to treat the seeds with recommended fungicide, and we have to avoid application of nitrogen fertilizer, excessive use of nitrogen fertilizer. We have to avoid for management of disease because of excess use of nitrogen fertilizer, pathologists have been observed increase in the disease intensity. This is all about rust disease of linseed.